Let's be a little more precise in our definition of strain. So if I have a bar and I pull on it, and it's deformed bar, looks like this, and as it's deforming, if I were to measure the displacement at any point, and then I were to plot that displacement, so in this case u of x is a function of x, what I would see is something like this, where this time the slope, I'm going to call it epsilon. This is not the Young's modulus, right? It's not stress versus strain, right? This is displacement versus position. I broke my own law. I said versus. Remember why I complained about that? It's displacement as a function of position. So if I then ask the question, let's define a point x1, u1, and another point u0 and x0. And I asked the question, if I gave you, given u0, x0, and epsilon, and x1, what is u1? Well, how would you come up with that? We'll just write down the equation of a line, right? So u1 is equal to epsilon x1 minus x0 plus u0. And then I'm just going to define a new variable. I'm going to define a new variable h that's x1 minus x0. And so I'm going to write u1. Now u1, u1 is u at x1, right? And x1, given this definition of h, x1 is x0 plus h, right? That's equal to epsilon h plus u at x0, all right? And then I'm just going to rearrange this equation. I'm going to solve for epsilon u at x0 plus h minus u at x0 over h is equal to epsilon. And then I'm just going to take the limit as h goes to 0. What's on the left side of that? What is this limit? It's the derivative. It's the derivative of u with respect to x. That's epsilon. And there's a good reason I use the symbol epsilon, because epsilon is what we typically use for strain. So the strain, this is in one dimension. We'll talk about how this generalizes to 2D next time. But in one dimension, mathematically, strain is the derivative of the displacement with respect to x, right? So then if we just go back to our conservation of momentum, again in 1D, we had the second time derivative of u is equal to, in 1D, the divergence is just equal to partial x of the stress, right? The stress, we'll now use Hooke's law and our definition of strain. So Hooke's law, E epsilon, but epsilon is that guy, right? And so then finally, if we assume E is a constant, then we just have that guy. And a lot of times you'll see this, you know, if you define, a variable C that's the square root of E over rho. So then the final form of this equation might be that guy. Anybody know what that's called? It's the wave equation. And we just define C to be the square root of this so that it just works out nicely that when you work, when you get the solution of this just involves a C. Right? And that C is the wave speed. So in one dimension, this is the wave speed of the material. The Young's modulus divided by the density is the wave speed of the material. And so often what we do in geology is we measure the wave speed somehow, right? And then we either measure the density or the Young's modulus and infer one from the other. Right? And so that's is one way we can get material properties. Yeah, so this is a wave equation. It's a partial differential equation. So just to be clear, U is a function of x and time. So we'll stop there, and next time we'll look at